I've been reporting on the topic of excessive SSD usage on the M1 Macs specifically since November. If you haven't watched my other videos, let me quickly bring you up to speed. Many users have reported that their Macs have written a ton of data to their internal SSDs in a very short amount of time. The concern is that each SSD has a finite lifespan, that is, they may start to degrade or even fail after a certain amount of data is written. This is generally referred to as the drive's TBW. Historically though, the amount of data that needs to be written to get anywhere near this level is huge, so it's never really been an issue. Recently, however, Macs have been utilizing something called swap memory, seemingly much more than usual, which I explained further in my previous video. After doing some research into this topic and spending a lot of time testing on my own Macs, I think I've narrowed down the cause of this issue and I've developed a method to avoid most of it or even fix it altogether. Spoiler alert, make sure you are on the latest version of macOS as of today, and try not to use unoptimized apps that are running on Rosetta 2. Now, with this strategy, I was able to reduce my swap memory usage by 75%, going from close to 400 gigabytes of swap memory being written to my SSD each day to under 100 gigabytes. And in this video, I'm going to show you how I did it. Firstly, let me show you what excessive swap usage actually looks like. In these screenshots, you can see I started tracking the total bytes written value for the kernel task process in Activity Monitor at exactly 12:33 a.m. on the 8th of March. The kernel task process is responsible for swap memory, among other things. Less than 3 hours and many, many YouTube videos later, at 3:12 a.m., don't judge me, I'm a night owl, that value had increased from 3.23 terabytes to 3.64 terabytes, or 410 gigabytes of swap data written to my internal SSD in under 3 hours. This is from relatively light Firefox, Chrome, Discord, and Mail usage. I cross-referenced this using a program called DriveDX, and sure enough, it matched. You can also use something called SmartMon Tools to find this information, but it was interesting to see that Apple's own reporting tool, Activity Monitor, matched up perfectly with a third-party app, DriveDX, and gave the exact same results. That's a pretty strong indication that this information is correct. Now, I don't know about you, but that's an insane amount of written data and is not normal at all. That being said, as you're about to see, when we dive into my base model M1 MacBook Air, on average, over the last few weeks, there was roughly 300 to 400 gigabytes being written to the SSD every day, including swap memory. That's about 120 terabytes per year. Now, we don't know exactly what SSDs Apple uses in their M1 Macs, but we do know they are very high quality and likely have a TBW of anywhere between 600 to 1000 plus. That means even at this insane rate of usage, I'd likely get a minimum of 5+ years out of my SSD before starting to see noticeable issues, likely much longer than that. So what could be causing this excessive usage exactly? Well, let's take a closer look on my base model M1 MacBook Air with 8 gigabytes of RAM and a 256 gigabyte SSD. Okay, so this is my base model M1 MacBook Air, obviously with just the 256 gigabyte hard drive. Now, first things first, what we're gonna do is we're gonna come into the Apple logo, we're gonna click About This Mac. You can see here currently I'm on version 11.1 of macOS. We'll come back to that later. We'll go to System Report, and then we'll come down here to the Software section. You can see the time since I last restarted this Mac was 23 days ago. So this computer has not been shut down for 23 days, it's just been put to sleep. And if we now close this down and we open up this screenshot from a week ago, you can see the date here is the 8th of March and the date now is the 15th of March. And I want to draw your attention to this particular process here, the kernel task. Now, I have discussed this kernel task briefly in my last video, but just pay attention here to the bytes written. Now, this is bytes written to the SSD, and that is 3.19 terabytes 7 days ago. And if I now open up Activity Monitor, you can see that that has now increased to 7.83 terabytes. So that is 4.64 terabytes in under 7 days of relatively light usage. Now, how do I define light usage? Well, I'll show you. As you can see here, I really don't have that much stuff open. Obviously, I have some things like Firefox. I've got a few small little apps. And if I actually open up Firefox, you can see here that I really don't have that many tabs open. I have no more than about 10 to 15 Firefox tabs open. I will have the Mail app with just a single account, and only about 100 or 200 emails in that account. I'll also sometimes have Google Chrome, but only one or two windows open, if anything. Very occasionally I'll have Discord, and sometimes I might be using the Notes app. But that is literally it. I've done nothing else over the last month, just very, very light usage. That's what I mainly use this particular laptop for. I don't do much hardcore editing on here, if any. It's really just stuff like Firefox. And you can see right now, I'm not really using a whole lot of memory. I'm currently using just under 2 gigabytes of swap, which is totally normal. Again, guys, swap is a normal thing. It's good. I'm not trying to say swap is bad. However, I will say that 7.83 terabytes written to the internal SSD in under 23 days is quite a lot, in my opinion. Comparing the DriveDX results from my video 2 weeks ago to today, you can see I wrote an extra 7.5 terabytes in 2 weeks, or over 500 gigabytes per day, every single day. Now, this is with about 8 hours of light to moderate usage, and mostly web browsing type stuff. So like I said before, guys, I have a hunch at what this particular issue could be. So if you look here in the kernel task, now this is responsible for a lot of things, but a lot of it is also swap, and that's what's going to be the majority of the bytes written. And I honestly think this issue is coming from Rosetta 2. Obviously, Rosetta 2 is what translates non-M1 compatible apps, which allows you to use them. So apps like Firefox, Discord, those kind of things, they're not natively M1 apps yet, unlike Google Chrome and, of course, obviously the native Apple apps like Safari. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shut everything down. I'm also going to update my software version to the most up-to-date version of macOS. Right now I'm on 11.1, so I'm going to update this. I'm going to restart the Mac, and I'm only going to use either Apple Silicon updated apps such as Google Chrome or the native Mac apps like Safari and Mail. And I'm not going to use apps like Firefox or Discord because I just want to see if we can actually reduce this particular kernel task result here of 7.83, I'm just gonna see if I can get that down as low as possible into more of what I would consider normal usage. So let me do that real quick, and I will actually see you guys in a couple of days once I've had a chance to test it out and see how it goes. Okay guys, so it is now just under 3 days since I last recorded that video. And as you can see, if we check the kernel task in Activity Monitor, the bytes written value is 291 gigabytes. And if we come over here to DriveDX, and you may remember from the last video, I was at 27.6 data units written. And as you can see here, I'm only at 28. So that's only 400 gigabytes written to the hard drive in the last 3 days, which really isn't too bad because I have been doing a lot of work. Now, to give you an idea of what exactly I've had open, well, I've had Safari. I've had all of my tabs in Safari. You can see all the notes for this video here. I've been doing a lot of WordPress stuff, a lot of YouTube videos. I watch a ton of YouTube videos. I've also had Google Chrome open the entire time. I've had probably 4 or 5 tabs open on Google Chrome. I've also had Apple Mail open. And from time to time, I would lightly use Discord and Word and also some Photoshop. But then when I finished using those apps, I would shut them down straight away. So it's good to see that I'm now using under 100 gigabytes a day compared to between 300 to 500 gigabytes a day prior to this. So like I said previously, I think it's a combination of Rosetta 2 and unoptimized apps. Now, just hold on a minute before you pick up your pitchfork and try and burn down the Apple head office. You got to understand that Apple has no control over these third-party apps. If they require more memory to run or they need Rosetta 2, so be it. User experience is the most important thing. That being said though, Apple should be putting pressure on the developers of these apps to release updated versions. I also think Apple should release some kind of official statement at the very least, saying they're aware of the concerns in the community and are looking into it. So what is the solution? Well, as you guys have seen here, try to use native Apple apps wherever possible, especially browsers. This is important. So definitely do use Safari instead of Google Chrome or Firefox. Firefox specifically, I've found to be really, really bad, at least on Apple Silicon. The other thing you can try is download M1 optimized apps, including DaVinci Resolve 17.1. I believe it's still in beta, but it is out. I've been using it in a few videos. And if you do have to use Chrome, you can actually download an Apple Silicon version of Chrome. But again, guys, apps like Chrome and also all of the Adobe apps, they're absolutely horrible. They're completely unoptimized. even on Windows and prior versions of Mac. So try to either limit usage or shut them down when you're not using them or just not use them at all. Now, continuing on from that, obviously you're going to have to use unoptimized apps like Photoshop or Discord, for example. So if that's the case, that's totally fine. And with this particular figure here, that was with Word, Photoshop, some Discord, all open at the same time and being used. But again, I used it and then I quit it as soon as I was done using it. So I honestly think this is a pretty easy fix. It doesn't require anything super drastic like disabling swap or anything like that. It just requires you to slightly modify your workflow. Now, it is important to mention that these steps are only for the short term and only for those currently experiencing excessive swap usage or those that are worried about it. I do believe this issue will be resolved very soon by either Apple releasing more software updates and more third-party apps being updated to run natively on Apple Silicon. So for the next couple of weeks, just try to follow the tips I've just mentioned and you should be fine. And I honestly think in a couple of weeks or maybe a couple of months at the max, everything's going to be fine. So what I'm gonna do now is just a little test. I'm gonna move all of these tabs from Safari over to Firefox. I'm gonna open up Discord again. I'm gonna be using Word in the background rather than using Docs in the cloud like I have been before. And I'm gonna give it about half an hour and we're gonna come back and see what the bytes written up here is looking like. So at the moment it's 293.07 gigabytes. So I'll see you guys in about half an hour. Okay guys, so it's been about half an hour here and as you can see, the bytes written has increased from 293.07 to 303.84. So that is almost 11 gigabytes in half an hour, which really isn't too crazy. What I've noticed is it's actually a lot better now that I've actually updated macOS, because prior to the update, that was just going out of control and it probably would have been close to 3 or 4 times that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna end this video here and I'm gonna do some more testing on this topic. What I'll probably do is I'll go back to what I was doing before. So I'll use unoptimized apps like Firefox and Discord and I'll give it a week or two, see how it goes, and I'll update you guys with another video. Anyway, apart from that, thank you for watching. Any comments or questions, let me know down below and I'll catch you in the next one.